Hello everyone, in this video I will show how to connect Java to MySQL database using DBCP library, or we can call database connection pooling library. And first step, we create the project and set up library. And create connection with MySQL. Insert, update, delete, and the last we select for display data. Now let's start. Now create new simple project in IntelliJ, so I'm going to use Maven project. In this file porm.xml, we need to add the library that we will use here. Here the database connection pooling library, and scroll down we see the Maven dependency, copy it to the project. And we need one more library, as MySQL connector J. For this library we use the version 8.3, now copy it. Then click on this button to load the library. So make sure your computer have network connection, because it need to download the jar library from the central Maven repositories. So next we create the project package. Then create main class for test. Next we going to create the connection class to MySQL database, by create new connection package. And create new database connection class. So in this class we use the singleton pattern. The singleton pattern has only one instance, and provides a global point of access to that instance. Here create the private static object. And create public static method to access that instance, call getInstance. So in this method we initialize that instance when instance is null. Then return the instance. And create the default constructor as private, because we do not allow to create new object from this class. Create method for connection. Go top here we need create the basic data source object, it from the commons DBCP2 library. This is the library that we have add to the porm.xml file. And here for the connection host. Use localhost, because we have connect to the local computer. This MySQL port, I have installed MySQL on port 3305, but if you are using default port, it should be 3306. This for database name, MUSDB tutorial. This for MySQL username. And the last is password. So this is my database info, to connection to my database. So you can change to your database name or your database username password. Here into method connect we initialize data source object here, and pass the connection info to this data source. This for MySQL connection string. Then call method start, but this method has throws error, so we can throws error here with SQL exception. So next we going to create the database, so I'm using Navicat Premium to control the database. Right click to your connection, and select create new database. Go back to your code and connect to this database. So we need use try catch. First call method connect to database. And we can test output here, to make sure the connection has success. Now let run this class. Here the output is success. So next we going to create the database table, by click on the new table button here. So the first column is product ID, and I set it to the primary key, and it gonna be unsigned and auto increment. And next column as product name. And next quantity stock. For this quantity stock column, we set the default value to 0. And next as sell price. Next as created date column to store the created record. updated date column and the last one as deleted date column. And for the created date and updated date, we set the default values to the current date, so we use now method. Then save it as product table. So now we have one table with empty record, so next we're going to insert data to this table, with connection that we have created in Java code. Here create new method for insert data. First create the connection from package java.sql, and assign it to null. And prepared statement, also from package java.sql. Then create try and finally. So in the finally block we need to close the connection and prepared statement. But we need to go the database connection class. We need create method to get new connection from the data source. And method get connection in data source has the throws error SQL exception, so we can throws here. Go back to insert method. Use method create connection that we have created. And we can create the prepare statement from the connection. So here we can write query to insert data into the table. For the column that we will insert data, have product name, product ID is auto increment so we no need to insert, also column quantity stock we have set the default values is 0, so we need inserts only product name and sell price. We set the table column here. And for the value we use question mark, we have two column, so we use it two question mark. For this insert method we also need to throw SQL exception. Then create the value for pass to this prepared statement. We have product name, set as source drinks for example. And sell price, it's number so we use double. Then here, we use method set string, with parameter index is 1. And set double with parameter index is 2. Then call method execute. So in the finally block here, we need to close the prepared statement and connection object. Then go to main method, and call method to insert. Now we can run. Here we see the output success, and we see the data in the table. So we can insert one more row. Here we have two rows, so next we're going to create method to update. For update, we can copy from insert method. And we need change the SQL query here to update query. So the column that we update is, product name, sell price. And updated date. We use now function to set as the current system date time. And use limit 1 because we update only one record. Here create variable ID for product ID that we want to update. Pass the ID for update to prepared statement. So it will update record where product ID is 1. Go copy this product name. And change it to sure the data is update. And we also update the sell price. Then in the main method, just call update method. Now run it. Here we need refresh data, and now we see the row product ID 1 has updated, and also for column updated date. And we can test another one. We update product 2. Now run it again. Here the data has updated. But we see the code that we have closed the connection in method update, and also the same in method insert. So we can create one method to close it. Go to class database connection, and create method as close. And create auto closable by using varargs, by use 3 dots before the variable name, so this method can accept 0 or more auto closable object as argument. And we use throws SQL exception to this method, then create try catch block here, And catch with error exception, because method close in class closable is need to throws that error type. Then we can throw with SQL exception here, so when we call this close method we need throws only SQL exception. Next loop the auto closable object, because it's array, then close it all. Now go back here, and change it to use method close. Close prepared statement first and then close the connection. And also in method update, so now we easy to close the connection after complete every transaction. So next we going to create method to delete record in table. Just copy the update method and create new delete method. So we can remove this, and we need only product ID for delete. Then change the SQL query here to delete query. Also remove this, and change parameter index for the product ID to 1. Now go to main method and call the delete method. But before delete I want to back up the database. So now go to run it. Here data has deleted, and we can delete another row. Now all data has deleted, so I need restore data back. So for delete row we don't delete like this, we just update the deleted date. So change the delete query to update query. So here we see the column deleted is null. Now run it. Now data has updated. Next we going to select data and display it. We can copy from the delete method. Change name to select. And remove this code. Then change update query to select query. Remove this because we no need pass any parameter. And change execute to execute query, because method execute query has return type of result set. So we need create the result set object here for store data that we have select. And don't forget to pass this result set object to close method. After get the result set we can use while loop to get the data. So the first column is product ID. We can use index number or specific the column name. Next product name. For the index is 2, but I recommend to use the column name. Next quantity stock. And next sell price. So now we can output it for test. Then go to main and call the select method. Let run it. Here we see two rows of product. But for the first row we have deleted by just update the deleted date, so we can select where the deleted date is null. Now run it. Here we see only one row of product. And here we can use the column name, so use the column that we want. And thank you everyone for watching, see you next video.